Good evening, guys and gals. In a departure from the norm, arch decoyer Geoff Garrod and a special young man, budding field sportsman and avid viewer of the shooting show, will introduce tonight's show.
Before we go any further, I'd just like to dedicate this episode of the shooting show to young Teddy Cole. He put a post up on Facebook, and I think doing a better job than Pete Carr introducing the shooting show. So this one's for you, Teddy.
Welcome to the shooting show. This week, we're shooting pigeons with Geoff Garrod.
Well, we're having another afternoon out on the pidge. The biggest thing that's changed, I've been watching this little spot here now for sort of like two or three afternoons now, and it was looking good, but the one thing that has really changed, which has altered things quite dramatically, is the wind. All week I've been watching this spot here with a sort of like a southwesterly wind blowing up this way. But today it's gone round to an easterly, northeasterly, so it's literally gone round 180 degrees, which means now that what I'm having to do, I'm still going to go in the same spot, but I'm changing from the 12 and I bought the 410 with a moderator on. So it's a Mossberg moderated 410. Purely and simply, if I was to sit here all afternoon banging away, have 100 shots, 150 shots, whatever, all this noise would be just going straight through the village. We're in a bit of a sensitive area where the first house is only 150 metres away from where we're going to be. And if the wind was in the west going that way, it would be fine. All the shot noise would be going away from the village. But it's because it's turned round, it'll be blowing all the noise into the village. So just a little bit of courtesy, really, and don't want people complaining too much. So I'm going to probably go in the same spot, but we're going to shoot this afternoon with the 410, obviously, because it'll just take the noise away. The moderator will take the noise, keep the noise down to really a bare minimum, and hopefully don't put too much disturbance on the village, and then thus hopefully not having any complaints from them. Normally you get the wind coming through here, so that's the whole idea of going in this corner here, but the wind's gone completely round, so the wind's now coming from the east, blowing it straight this way. I'm still going to go here because of the location and the vicinity of the village behind us. I can't really go anywhere else here, again, hence the reason why I'm shooting the 410 this afternoon, because all the noise, everything shot we take, will be the noise will be going straight in the village. So I'm going to go here, I'm going to have a few decoys out that side of the hedge, have some here on this little block of maize here, and then a few pigeons, decoys out in front of us here. And with the wind, pigeons are going to be coming through the gap. That little tree there, I've noticed, is a really nice city tree. If they're not sure, hopefully they'll go into that, and then we'll have that covered as well. So that's the plan. Just need to set up and see what happens. I thought I kept seeing a shadow coming across my left. Every time I looked, I kept seeing there's a bit of cotton hanging off me brow and my hat. And every time I moved, it looked like it was a shadow going across. Anyway, we got rid of that. I seem to be coming around the back into the tree or coming over the top of that tree, which has given me a good shot here, or that lot went out and sort of come back. I think, thankfully, because of the not too much noise and this little bit of wind, they're getting not wary of it straight away, so. What they're doing is that there's quite a few sort of, well, not quite a few, but one or two go round it, and then the odd one will sort of go into it, and then I'm getting some sort of coming sort of down across here.
Right.
So at the moment, the sort of killing zone, sort of like that block of sky just to the left of that tree there. Oh, nice little right and left. Might come round this way. One coming from the left, might be a shot. Not sure where it's going. It's gone around the back of us, but it looked keen. Is it going to come back? Oh, at the wrong end. Been there. Oh, look out, look out. Yeah, James, come in. In the deeps.
I got that. We'll cut out the first two shots. It looked great.
Perhaps be a bit of authentic. Just cut the first shot out. Yeah. Tell you, yeah, oh, look out. What's he doing? Might be coming up in the tree, James, how that one was acting. Tell you what, wind's changed.
Yeah.
That's probably half the reason. That's blowing all them feathers down there now.
Yeah.
That's probably half the reason why they don't want to come in.
Right.
So we'll have to have a bit about that, and which means. hopefully I'll get a few more deeks out there in the actual rake that just might stand out a bit more. I'll put a flapper out in a minute. Good old flapper. When we first got here, and as we're standing in the hide now, when we first got here, the wind was coming literally straight in our face. Straight like down, straight across the field, through this gap here. So we had all the pigeons sort of like facing that way and that way, that way. But I don't know, we've been in here probably about 3/4 of an hour, shot 15 pigeons. And the last couple of pigeons, I just noticed that I killed them and the feathers were blowing down that way. So gone out in the decoys, got a couple of feathers, chucked them up in the end. Sure enough, the wind has gone from its normal way where it was to start with there to basically coming down here now. So it's shifted a quarter. So I had to go out there and just rearrange the decoys to take into consideration how the wind's moved.
Okay, and you've added a flapper as well, haven't you?
Yeah, just an ordinary flapper. Went to get there, the crocodile clip had broke. So luckily I had a bit of tape, taped it all back up and we're up and running, or should I say up and flying.
What's that 410 like to shoot with? Is it harder to shoot a 12 than a 12?
Well, in actual fact, you know, it's a fair bit of metal there with the pump, you know, the breech, and also with the moderator on it. So you've got the weight near enough of a 12. So really, it's not as bad as I thought it was going to be when it comes to swinging and pointing. It feels real good. It's just a matter of putting the shot in the right place. And I think, you know, if you put the shot in the right place, it will do the job. Sure. So it's a nice actual gun that you can get up and swing with it, you know, and feel comfortable with it as well. Oh, like that one there. I'm shooting a Eley extra long, so it's 18 gram of shot. So you've obviously got a very small pattern going out there. You hardly got any shot going out there. So you really have to be on the front end of them or get them coming as close to you as you can, you know, so get more killing. But, you know, they'll probably kill 25 yards comfortable, you know, I would say 20 to 25 yards comfortable. But you have to be at the front end. Yeah, it's coming in, that's coming in. I don't honestly know what choke it is on there. But it's doing a job. If you're on them, you know, it's doing a job. James, it's one here. It's one here, James. James, come and have the top here. Yeah. Oh, you turn like that. I did get right and left there. James, coming in from the left. Nah, too far. I might come back round, no. Oh, here come one. No. Look at That's another day done, but obviously we've been shooting with a 410 Mossberg. Three-shot moderator. We're using this today because of the proximity of where we were to the village. We didn't want to be using the 12 gauge banging away, especially with how the wind has changed today and it's blown all the shots right into the middle of the village there. So that was the biggest reason why we were using this today, to keep the noise down. It's been a difficult day, I have to say. With the wind in her face, the birds just came up the hedge. There was no way could we get out the front of the hide or the back of the hide, because we'd have been full sun. So we was this side of the hedge, the birds just come over the hedge, boom, in. I wouldn't say they decoyed the best today. A lot of birds were just going straight over the top, but some come in, and it was testing shooting with the 410. The birds going out. The best shooting that we had was when they came over that tree there and give me a cross shot. I seem to get on better with them. I think we finished up with just over 70. And unfortunately, there is one or two in the rape that I ain't had a chance to pick up, but that's just how it goes. I'm not sure how many shots I've had. I will actually count the shots. It's not going to be a good score, but I have to say, using the Eley extra long cartridges, when you was on them, boy, did that kill them. But it was getting on them. All in all, I've enjoyed the day. It's been a bit frustrating how the birds just didn't really want to commit to the decoys. I think perhaps another situation, and the wind in a different direction today, might have been a 100-plus day today. But I'm happy with what we've got, it's been a good day, and the bottom line of it is we're trying to keep these pigeons off the rape again. Trusty George, didn't have to save a lot of miles on the old legs, and we need that nowadays, don't we, mate?
Well, that's it for this week. Thanks for watching, and thanks to Geoff Garrod and young Teddy there. And please like us on Facebook and follow us on Twitter. And if you're not a member of BASC, it really is time to join now. BASC, looking after your sport, looking after you. This has been The Shooting Show.